Hello and welcome. I'm Impact Frames. In this video, we're going to take a look at Animatediff for Automatic 1111. And first of all, let me thank everyone that has been subscribing to the channel. It's been super, super amazing, unreal, the amount of likes that the last video got. I'm super happy and I hope I can keep up to expectations of everyone. And here we are with Animatediff. And as you can see, this is made with the two control nets and the prone traveling, the new options for Animatediff that you can give it like a description of what you want to see on each frame, and it will travel from one prompt to another. And it's using the underlying video as a control net for the tile resampler. And then I have a picture from the girl that I made for the AI girlfriend video for the text generation web UI. I show how to make characters for an AI girlfriend, and you basically, she has a personality and everything, and now you can see her moving, and maybe in the future she will be for real, she will have a body. I will make a robot when we have like a million subscribers. And now I'm gonna show you some more tests that I did. This one is quite spicy because I forgot to make a negative prompt, and I was using a strong mold here. And basically this one is one of the best examples because everything is made just with prone traveling. There is no IP adapter, nothing. Anyway, another test. This one is using IP adapters and the prone traveling, but it's not using another control net to guide the motion. It's just the prone traveling plus the IP adapter to make the thing. This one is using image to image with one image as a initial image. The concept of doing it this way is that it has less motion. So it has less motion, and I did one with the final image with image to image. And this one has a hand in the final image, and the in-betweening is getting unexpected results because it's having the hand in there. So the moral of the story is don't use hands in your images. And here I'm gonna show you, I use this image. This is an stock footage. This is the initial image that I use, and here is the result with just animated diff. This is how your image is supposed to go when you are halfway the generation. You should see like a bunch of thumbnails with the different motions of your thing. If you see something like this, cancel everything because it's going awry. And this one is another example of something that can go wrong when you are using image to image. And you have a 50% image with no final image, it can go really bad like this. So I'm gonna show you now how to install it. So here we are in the repo for the Animatediff extension. And yeah, please give it a star in here so we support the guy and maybe the Ko-fi page. And this is the Hugging Face repo from the creator of Animatediff. And these are the molds he trained for the motion models. You can train these models. I'm maybe gonna make a video on how to train this. Yeah, you can download these loras and put it in your models loras folder, and you can come in here. I will get this motion model 1.5 because it's trained with the 32 frames context. In the 1.5 you have a bigger movement, but in the 1.5 B2 you have a smaller movement but a lot better consistency. And there are other molds that you can get from the Hugging Face, like the temporal diff. I think there is one for temporal diff. And yeah, there are more things that you can download from there. I'm gonna go and show you how to use Animatediff. First, we're gonna go and see where to install these things. And as you can see here, we are in the Stable Diffusion Web UI folder, extensions, the Animatediff repo, models, and you put your things in here. I don't have them right now in here because I'm using another location. I'm gonna show you how to use it in another location. To use it in another location, you're gonna go into Stable Diffusion and you go into settings, and there is Animatediff here. And in here you put your location where the models are. I have it in config UI. And also you can choose these optimizations. The GIF cycle is only for Linux because the GIF cycle is not available for Windows as far as I know. And to install this, you need to enter in the VM and sudo apt install and GIF cycle in there. You do that command and you can install it. And in here, you can choose the optimizations. I'm using a scalar.product because this one gave you like, you can use this with 5 gig of RAM. And for Xformers, you need about 6. Or you can choose not to use any optimization, which is crazy. Yeah, that's for the optimizations. And also, if you go into optimizations in here, make sure to select the path negative and positive prompts to make the prompts the same size. That way, it will get less confused if you use this option. Yeah, so let's go into text to image and see how to make this wonderful animation. And basically, you open your animated div. In animated div, you can load a video, and this is the girl that the original video is from. As you can see here, it's making the same movement. Maybe sometimes I catch it in the same frame. I don't know, maybe. Right? Okay. So as you can see here, it's the same video. She's making the same movement and stuff. And this video is passing as a control net for the tile blur. I have the first control unit. If you don't put anything here, the video will be the control net. And you can use open pose, but I think the tile blur for this example is a lot better. I'm using a weight of 0.6. And let me zoom in here so you can see better my settings. So basically, you don't put anything in here, and it will be the video from the animated div that will control the thing. You can also use low VRAM if you have very low VRAM. But for now, I think this is the way it works best, and I will put it in 0.6. And as a second control net, I will put the IP adapter, the girl that I told you I made the character from, and I use 0.45. And that will give me like a good, as you can see here, it gives me a good relationship between the original and this. Yeah, so that's the way I use it in here. Everything in here, it populates automatically from the video, like the 74 frames, 10 frames per second, because I pass this in Premiere Pro and make it like a lot less resolution. I download this video from YouTube and then I make it a lot less frames per second in Premiere Pro. Maybe I can show you that, how to use it in Premiere Pro. If you come here and you export the video, you can select a bit less or more of the frames. And then in export, I select here PNG. Or you can put H.264, and instead of 30, you can put 10. The lesser that you can, if you can put 8, you put 8. And you can even export this as a PNG if you like another way from Premiere Pro. But this video is not about Premiere Pro, so we want to keep going with the stable diffusion and show you the other settings. And basically, I'm using quite high res in here. And as you can see, everything in here is coming straight without any high resolution or anything, and not doing image to image. Everything is like the first result. And I'm using 536 for 960 for this quality. But if you have a lesser card, I recommend you something like 448 by 640 because it's something that the VRAM can handle. And then the sampling steps, I'm using 40 DPM plus to MSD carrots. And for the prompt traveling, I put like the frame and then the column and then what I want to see in the frame. And as you can see here, I'm using face, looking at the viewer, open mouth, open eyes, and like that. And you can see here a smile happy, in the 24 frame column. So you have that nomenclature or kind of the naming convention for making this prone traveling, okay? And if you use prone traveling alone, like if you are using no video on the thing, then you will need to set in the animated diff. You will make sure that here you have at least the same amount of frames that you have in the prone traveler. Because I have 32 here, I had to put a little bit more so it come back in the closed loop. The closed loop, what it does is attempt to have the first frame as the last frame. So it will try to blend in here. If you put 32, it won't be enough. So you have to put something more like 44. And then in here, I put the frames per second. If you are doing film, like in the other thing that I showed you, you could use the forum to do the interpolation. But when you're using 8 frames per second, the frames, maybe it's not too smooth. And if you want to achieve very smooth results, then you can use something like the flow frames. This is a repo that you can use, as you can see here. You can put twice the frames per second or even 4 times. And it will, the AI will create the in-between frames and will make the animation a lot smoother. And I think this thing can even upscale your image. So yes, this thing can upscale your image. So if you want to do everything afterwards in flow frame, you can, and actually try to support this guy because this guy also has a repo for SD, for stable diffusion. It's super cool. Yeah, so it's a lot of work that maybe will be cool that if someone can help in, yeah. And another thing that you may be able to use .com, because I don't want to give my information to all these vendors. I don't use this, I use Premiere Pro, but you can use this to separate your frames and do all of that, or you can use Adobe Express, this website, I'm gonna link it, to copy your frames. And another thing that you can use, Champ. This is a new software by Microsoft, it's free to use, and it's super cool, very easy to use, I love it. If you want to make super quick editing, you can use this app, cool. I'm gonna link it in the description also. And finally, this is Facefusion. How to use Facefusion? It will be super easy. You put your source in here, you select your frame enhancers and stuff. And these things take a lot to, I don't know, it actually download quite quick because they are small, most like 500 megabytes. And you can use the CPU and everything if you want to use. This is a super great result, and you can see here. Yeah, and that's the difference between animated diff and this. I made another video. Please go and watch that video, how to install this thing. If you have inconvenience on how to install it, there is also Pinocchio to install these things for you. And you can see it here in the description. There is Pinocchio, and this is the installation help. They also have a Discord to help you to install this thing if you want. So that was all for today. I think it was a lot. I am also getting very dry. You can see here the prompts that I use. Also, you can use my prompt maker to get your loras in here for your movements. Like you have the lora pan left, pan right, and stuff. You can get it from here, and you get the right kicking words, the trigger words, and the weight and everything. So you can have the weights and everything here. You can select another one. And this is my own extension that you can get it also from the extensions. You can install it from here the same way you install diff. You can go into available, search for it, and load it. And it will be if from maker, animated diff, and also segment anything. I recommend you to get this. Yeah, that was all. I show you also how to get these things in my last video. If you go and watch it, you can see how to get it. If you're using high res fix, I don't recommend you to use high res fix at the same time. I told you that you can use flow frames for that. Or you can use image to image to get that thing. And I think that's all I can help you with for now for this video. I hope you like the video and enjoy it. And maybe in the next video, I'm going to show you how to use these same things, but for animation, for cartoon things, for anime, because you can do way more with anime. Okay, sorry, I forgot to tell you some more things about the image to image tab and the move to move tab, and basically some things that you can use in here. Basically, you can use more control nets, the weights. I told you that you have to be like conservative with the size of the weight in here. When you are using prompts, if you are not using too much of the prompt and you are going like image to image, it's better not to use any prompting here when you are using image to image, unless there is something that you don't want to see. And if you load some image in here, like for example, an start, like I have here the start that I made with the IP adapter with the character that I made before, and you're using image to image, you can go from 100% in here. And for the last image, you should load something here. This one is for loading a last image. And I told you how to make, I don't have one in here, but it will be this one. If I did the IP adapter, I want that as the end. If you have the movie part, this won't be too much of a troll to have the sequence not following the prompt, like in the examples of the test that I told you. You can improve all of that. You can have more context if you are using an A100. You can have more context in here, the stride. If you put this one, can go up to 2. And this one, what it's doing is dividing by 4 the context. The overlap is using a quarter of the, it will be using a quarter of the total of the context. And basically, if you're using 16, it will use 4 frames. And in here, the stride will make it more stream, the change. If you put too much in here, it will be too big of a change. So it's better to use one. And this one is awesome, but you need a bigger card. And the same for the frames per second. I already explained how to get around the frames per second with the flow frames. And the control nets, if you are using the video that you loaded from here, if you're using the video, everything will load here in automatically, right? And you can use a normal if you are not happy with the mold that you have. You can try this temporal diff that is, I tried it, but it didn't run in my machine. I don't know, maybe it's my machine. And yeah. And thank you very much for watching this. And yes, I hope it was a video that you can use. Bye.